Okay, good morning. Today is Wednesday, what, August 9 and 2023. So we're continuing the discussion of evolution on Earth and the solar system, cosmogenesis to cosmic plan and ET Earth history. From the raw material, the detail last week, talking about a little of milk, moving from the discussion of Maldek and Mars through Bigfoot to the present time. In today's material, starting on what I have is page 20 of the PDF, the section called Martian Transfer Evolution from Apes. Ra gets into more of the detail of just how a transition, how the transition from second density to third happened on planet Earth. Bear in mind that first density, second density, fourth, fifth, sixth density, time, the length of time for those cycles on a planet is quite long, while third density is very small, which is related to, in some sense, the simplicity of what has to be achieved in third density. Ra talking about earlier densities as a foundation upon which the structures are built later. The hinge of soul evolution being third density choice. And third density, like third ray for the Logos, is very special. And also, understanding the transition of the planet from second to third density, beings in bodies from second to third density beings, we can understand, or I see a lot of relevance with both the nature of third density evolution to four and the work of negatively oriented humans and their 4D negative Orion masters to prevent or stymie or slow or damage soul evolution of third density beings. Keeping beings stuck in the lower triad keeps them repeating in third density, stymies in a sense soul evolution, and how far that can go has been, a matter of my hand-wringing for a while that some of these souls may become completely unviable in the future. Specifically, the point is that what brings second density beings and bodies to three is when reversed, keeps third density beings cycling in third density. When reversed, in a sense, they can't make the leap to harvest to four. And healing and balance is the work of moving from third density evolutionary blockage to harvestability to four. And then the opposite work of the negatives, keeping beings from harvesting or growing or learning and growing, is an opposite treatment of the lower triad than the healing and balance process that leads to ascension or a harvest to the next density. So, some of that will be spelled out a little bit more detail. I'll just jump in, continuing session in session 19. Here we are talking 19.5. Dawn, again talking about the planetary process. He asks, when the first second density entities became third on this planet, was this with the help of the transfer of beings from Mars, or were there second density entities that evolved into third density with no outside influence? So this references the Yahweh assistance of 3D souls from Mars immigrating or taking human body here, and many settled in the Middle East, so you know, and the issues therefrom, basically, what was dramatized 2,000 years ago, particularly 3,000, 4,000, the Middle East, the saga of the Middle East, the so-called Holy Land, really is deeply nested in the metaphysics of Yahweh's Martian transfer, the transfer of 3D Martian souls to Earth, and Yahweh's assistance and further assistance, and Orion's counterplay, and how that worked out. How'd that work out for you? So it's complicated. Ra explains answering the question regarding the second density entities here moving to third as another portion of the root population of Earth 75,000 years ago. I believe Ra said 50% Martian, 25% native, and 25% from elsewhere or other 3D planets. Ra explains, 19.5, there were some second density entities which made the graduation into third density with no outside stimulus but only the efficient use of experience. Others of your planetary second density joined the third density cycle due to harvesting efforts by the same sort of sending of vibratory aid as those of the Confederation send you now. This communication was, however, telepathic rather than telepathic vocal or telepathic written due to the nature of second density beings. And then Ra will explain who sent the aid in 19.6, which is the first long presentation teaching upon the Confederation of Planets and what that's all about. Very real and similar to the Federation of Star Trek, but a lot more spiritually oriented, not technologically worshipping. So, Ra's explaining, yes, there were some second density entities, like what, apes or horses? I don't know if they were dogs and cats 75,000 years ago or what. There were some entities, second density beings, that could make the transition with only what they call the efficient use of experience. Bear in mind that when Ra, like the discussion of what inspiriting is, inspiriting is not inspiriting. Inspiriting is becoming aware of light, indwelling light, logoic light, the higher aspects of one's own being. Likewise, later you'll see the term the efficient use of catalyst, and in the tarot and in the series of seven archetypes of mind, positions 3 and 4 is catalyst and then experience. It's actually the efficient use of catalyst to generate evolutionary or polarizing supportive experience. Generating the experience that supports our evolution from catalyst. That's the efficient use of experience. So, like I said before, when we don't know something, we ask a question. The focus then is on using the question to know more about the subject matter, meaning giving answers. When answers are then given, the next focus is comprehending the answers. So the next question pertains to what is now what was previously an answer, or my answer now becomes the topic or the focus, and then we go questions regarding the answer, or more questions, and a deeper progressive analysis. And that's what that's brightening the light. That's very Blu-ray, and that's appreciating everything's everything, and knowing is endless. So, okay, some entities got to third without out so-called outside stimulus, and then others, however, of our planetary second density, meaning other animal or plant or tree. Tree, plant, whatever, join third density cycle due to harvesting efforts by the same sort of sending of vibratory aid. This is a kind of spiritual investment, but again, it's an inspiriting that is not the acquisition of something, but sending love light that some beings will be able to use as catalyst for greater self-awareness, for greater development of awareness of what they are. Of their total true nature. that communication obviously was telepathic energetic, not telepathic vocal or telepathic written, not transfer of thought form, not thought form transfer particularly, but pure energy without thought form, like sending love light, may not be too heavy on thoughts of I love you, may you be well and happy. That may be where one starts, even like Brahma Viharas. We start with may you be well and happy, may all beings be well and happy, may all beings be in peace, whatever. But actually, once that thought is generated and transmitted, you don't need to keep thinking it, actually. So this is telepathic, energetic, holistic almost, not thought form based. Okay. The point is that evolution proceeds by call and response, individuation, or what's commonly called enspiriting, spiritual development. Continuing, not just the initial 2 to 3D awareness of spirit, of indwelling spirit, you know, that's what awareness of the upward spiraling light of each cell or atom or consciousness is all about. It's awareness of what similar to the sixth and seventh density aspects of the rock and the plant and the animal's own total true nature, right? Rocks and plants and animals are seven-dimensional beings or beingnesses, as we are, activated to 1-2 mind-body complex or mind bodies, not yet mind-body spirit. Human here with free will, mind, body, spirit complexes. Okay? So that awareness of what's called spirit, which is really the indwelling light of any being, supports their evolution from 2 to 3. Likewise, love, this enspiriting so-called, which is not. It's an expanded awareness. It's basically expanding awareness into what's called the spiritual. That's a deeper understanding of enspiriting or spiritualization. But likewise, healing and balance for us also is an enspiriting or a is the work of furthering that awareness of higher true nature or holistic true nature. Higher doesn't only mean. Doesn't mean higher without the lower. Higher means wider or more expansive, broader, deeper, all, more holistic, more encompassing, not higher rejecting lower. And so the columnar vertical nature of the chakras gives rise to lots of misspeaking and thinking. Me too, saying going higher. Nityananda said, you know, every moment is a test to see if we can go higher. Higher means greater, expanded, more broadly, more spherical, awareness of a greater sphere of nature of being, awareness, greater awareness or increasing awareness of the multidimensional true nature. How's that? Okay, who sent aid to the second density beings? Don asks at 19.6. Ross said, and here's the lead in to the first longer presentation of the Confederation. We call ourselves the Confederation of Planets in service of the Infinite Creator. Later they'd said one Infinite Creator. This is a simplification in order to ease the difficulty of understanding among your people. We hesitate to use this term sound vibration understanding, but it's closest to our meaning. So there's two stepping downs that they're indicating. Number one, the term they're giving, the Confederation of Planets in service of the Infinite Creator, is itself a simplification. Then, even the term understanding is a simplification, or a drop down from what it really means. So, dimension of love and understanding, fourth density, fourth chakra, love and understanding, unconditional acceptance is love, is of understanding. Ross said understanding is not of your density. All right. So it's a goal to seek. It's ever ahead as a touch as a sort of North Star, seeking of understanding. So okay, so they're real sticklers for precision in language terminology, which is great, you know, rectification of names and Confucius, and that's very important. Okay, so the simplified term for the collective here that they are a member of is Confederation of Planets in Service of the Infinite Creator. Dawn follows that, not yet ready actually to ask in depth about this confederation, because this was probably the first time it came up, or the first time Rod l goes into the detailed explanation. 1907, Dawn asks, then the confederation also aided in second density to third density transition. Is this correct? Ra explains, 1907, we must qualify correctness of this query. So queries go deeper. More qualifications are required to deepen so-called understanding. Okay, they say, we must qualify correctness of this query. A portion of the Confederation, which is not working with third density, but finds its aid best used in other harvests, that is, the second density harvest, is responsible for aid in these harvests of second density beings. The Confederation, as we have stated previously in these sessions, is composed of many of those in other densities, in your own density, within your planetary sphere, and within the inner or angelic realms. Each of those entities developing a mind-body-spirit complex, and then developing a social memory complex, and then dedicating this social memory complex to the singular service to the one creator, may join the Confederation. And 19.8, Don didn't pick up on it because he need to regroup and develop questions for the next session. Did the second density to third density transition take place 75,000 years ago? Yes, it's correct. So we're at the end now of the third major cycle of about 25,000 years. This confederation, the Ra's answer, of course, is very rich. So there is a portion of the Confederation that works significantly or possibly exclusively with second density groups harvesting to third. There are wanderers on Earth who are from those groups who are here not for humans. They're here to bring, you know, love, light. I mean, they of many life purposes, in service to others. Those life purposes associated with service to other, in the formal way, really interactive or relational, may be here actually to help plants and animals, not humans directly. And those are people who work with plants and animals commonly. People who love plants and animals and have a hard time with humans, understandably, may well be from some of those, from that portion of the Confederation. So there is guidance, and there are some, I would imagine, 4 and 5 and 6 density groups that specialize in second density beings. Then there's the explanation of an intro, first pass, teaching on the membership of the Confederation, composed of many in those in other densities. Well, what others are we talking about? It would be obviously 3, 4, 5, 6, because the requirement, or particularly 4, 5, 6, and possibly not much 3, meaning there are not many or any third density social memory complexes in the Confederation, in this Confederation, because there are others. It's this Confederation, not the Confederation. The Confederation means this galactic sector Confederation. So what's required, though, is mind-body-spirit complex, meaning self-consciousness, meaning a third density soul evolution, then social memory complex, which normally doesn't happen in third density, then it being dedicated to the social memory complex, being dedicated, you know, committed to the positive path, service to the one infinite creator, which means, so, you know, it's kind of lame even to say service to the one creator, because at another point they say all service is service to the creator. If all there is the one infinite creator, look around you, see the creator, then all activity could be labeled service to the one creator. There's nothing but the one creator. All activity is the one creator, serving itself. Ooh, it's on the negative path. You know, it gets lame at that point, really. All is one, the one is the one infinite, the source of light is the true nature of light. The source of creation is the nature of creation. The true nature of creation is its source, its true being, nature, is the nature of its source. The one infinite greater, intelligent infinity. And since all activity is of that one for itself, then it could be called service to the one infinite greater, positive and negative path. So at this point, it's not quite helpful. We've got first pass answers being analyzed by those who are looking at fourth level teaching, fourth level understanding. And so all social memory complexes could be called serving the one infinite creator, but we're really talking about positive path. We're really talking about service or action. I mean, all action is service. So you see, a lot of these words fall away when you go deeper. Service is not service. Service is life. All of life is the one creator acting or appearing to act or being or appearing to be. You know, as perception expands, explanations must radically shift. And that's how you know someone's growing, is their comprehension is mirrored by refinement in expression. So, okay, we're talking about those dedicated to service, to the path of love, the path of love and unity. From third density, fourth, fifth, sixth density, at least, maybe seven, but probably not, actually. I think 3 through 6, and mainly 4 through 6. In your own densities, there are 3D adepts who are in the physical body who are part of the Confederation. There are adepts who are on the inner planes, which means within your planetary sphere. It could be subterranean, but I think the definition is, the question is, what is planetary sphere? Is planetary sphere physical only? Of course not. So then we're talking about physical, non-physical sphere. What's the non-physical sphere? Well, so-called inner planes. What's that? Inner to what? Inner to the outer. What's the outer? The outer is space, time, or physical. The inner is time, space, non-physical. All right? So in the non-physical time, space, astral plane, the levels, the upper astral plane, you know, and Earth's fourth and fifth and sixth density energy fields as well, which could be called, quote, inner. The putting the words inner and angelic together, I don't like, but you know, because the angelic hierarchy is its own evolutionary line. They're not physical beings, yes. And so they are inner, yes. Inner in the sense that it's subtle, not coarse or gross. It's the subtle, not the gross. The subtle being non-physical, invisible energy fields, not physical, fleshy, chemical bodies. Okay. The angelic hierarchy is such, starting with second density beings. So there are second density Devic, angelic, I'll call them Devic groups that work with plants and animals and rocks, of course. And then third and fourth and fifth and sixth density angelic groups and entities that work with human evolution and other things too. So that's, quote, inner, but inner, not all inner is angelic. And each one is on the positive path. And that's the Confederation. And from a much earlier portion of this PDF or readout, 14.4, just to review, the multiple attempts of this Confederation to aid humanity. First, 75,000 years ago, with the Martian transfer assistance from Yahweh, genetic modification. 58,000 years ago in Mu, where they couldn't quite pick up the ball. Negatives and positive, Orion and the Confederation at that time in Mu, both, I think, had limited effect because they were very mellow. They were like long hair Indonesian surfers. Then we have the next one, long in coming, 13,000 years ago, 11,000 BC, before the fall of Atlantis, in Atlantis some intelligent information. It may have been intelligent information. It means information regarding intelligent energy. Healing crystals, and that was super duper abused or used for the destruction of their landmass, oh, their continent. Haha. Then, gotten for punishment, they came in again at 11,000 years ago, 9,000 BC. So, Atlantis was still rocking 9,000 BC. That's interesting, but soon fell very quickly, was over in a couple hundred years. And that was it. And then 3,500 years ago, they're saying approximations in time. And so 11,000 years ago in Egypt, the Egyptian portion of Atlantis. Then their sort of partner group came to South America. 3,500 years later, so I mean 3,500 years after 11,000, could be, yeah. So that was what, 7,500 BP before now, or 5,500 BC? The timing is, imperfect. And then you've got, it's every single story. The pyramids in South America, quote, were not to be used in the appropriate fashion. The crystal technologies and intelligent information given to Atlantis was not to be used in the appropriate fashion. The pyramid at Giza was not to be used in the appropriate fashion. Tesla technology was not to be used in the appropriate fashion. Seems like a whole lot of offering of unsuitable fashion. So that's interesting. And that will be fully unpacked later. 19.9, moving further, Don asks, where did the second density beings get physical vehicles of third density type to incarnate into? It's a really good question. Ra explained, there were among those upon this second density plane, meaning 75,000 years ago and prior, Earth was second density only, there were those upon this second density plane, those forms which, when exposed to third density vibrations, became the third density, as you would call sound vibration human entities. That is, there was loss of body hair, as you call it, clothing of the body to protect it, changing of the structure of neck, jaw, and forehead in order to allow easier vocalization, and the larger cranial development characteristic of third density needs. This was a normal transformation or transfiguration. Don follows up, over approximately how long a period of time does or was this transfiguration? It must have been very short. He's smart. Ra said, the assumption is correct, at least in our terms. Within a generation and one half, as you know these things, those who had been harvested of this planet were able to use the newly created physical complex of chemical elements suitable for third density lessons. So a generation and a half. A generation is, I learned 30 years, commonly now the revised reality online shows 20 to 30 years. Let's say 25 years, one and a half is 37.5 years, so 30 to 40 years, about 35 years, or something like that. That's interesting. Now, you basically have the arising of a new race of human beings in a period of 35 years. Mm-hmm. Saturn return plus a little. That's interesting. And later, Ra will explain how that happened. So, okay. But before, evolution precedes, the one is reached by a long process of interplay of polarity. Polarity interplay is the mode of seeking and finding the one. The polarities are everywhere. The polarity of day, night, one has to rest to have energy to work or seek or find or process. Then one is tired and rests again. There's the incarnative phase of working in darkness with a tiny candle. And there's the post-incarnative or time-space intermission, before birth, after death, where one does deeper self-understanding by life review and preparation and planning, assessing, taking stock of one's evolution, and making plans for further development, and countless other polarities are in play. So the hairy animal loses body hair and weakens. Yes, the body is weaker. And, you know, you can see the Malkushans, those guys on Star Trek with a big, big head, and they're all telepathic, and they keep races in cages for for learning. I think it's Malkushans. that's our evolutionary future. Uh-huh. Doesn't look very, very lovely to me. Physically, no. But it's the development of mind and spirit from a prior condition of full body identification, body only, right? The animal working on instinct, which Ra calls intuition, or the instinctual body genetic basis of intuition, with a big, strong body that can withstand the elements pretty well. Human body then gets weaker, or is weaker, is less vital than the animal body, so that beings will then focus attention on mind and interaction. Interaction, or the weakening of the physical body to some degree, is so that beings will depend on each other. The beings must depend on each other for survival, rather than the animal that is, as Ra said, more self-sufficient, even though there's less of a sense of a self. So less self, but stronger body, more so-called self-reliant, goes to third density, weaker body, less vital, less self-sufficient, more interactive, requiring more interaction with other and mental development, which helps evolve the being from a very thick, you know, animalism, to the crucifixion, the soul on ice, as Eldridge Cleaver would say. Soul on ice is deity, divinity, the spark of deity in a fleshy form with self-consciousness in between the animal and the divine. The cross of changes, enigma, the enigma of the cross, of the pinned position to the rosy cross, to the center of the cross of horizontal, vertical, the crucifixion of human life, the crucificatory, the crucifictional, not very fictional, the crucifictional nature of the human status. The human status is very special. Gautama said, you know, it's a precious human birth. Now, don't forget, you can attain Nibbana in higher stages from higher densities, of course. But the human stage is really the pathos of Logos. The pathos of Logos is the human stage of evolution. Third ray, third density. That's why the Logos has such a big issue with it. It's basically Godhead that is but cannot. The Godhead that is but cannot is the human state, the human condition. Godhead, knowing its infinite, its nature as infinity, sensing, and ever, for us who are learning, seeking to learn, grow, ever seeking, finding the greater reality of true nature, which is not our true nature, it's true nature, although I may say our true nature, because I am not always name rectified. So true nature, intelligent infinity, yeah, that's the true nature, known by an illusory self, or a self that is ultimately a deceit, meaning separation. There is no separation. It's limited perception that gives us atta, and greater perception we see anatta, the sunya of atta, which is, you know, non-duality. So sensing glory, but unable to actualize. This is the cross of changes. This is the human crucifixional stage of evolution. The yellow. That's why Coldplay said yellow. I know their source. their source is not human, for Yellow. They're talking about the tragedy, poignancy of the Yellow, actually. And so the body hair is gone, got to protect this weak, fragile body with clothing. And then also structure of neck, jaw, forehead to allow easier vocalization. You don't vocalize with your forehead, you know. It's the frontal lobes. And you can definitely, definitely know a soul's evolution to some degree by the physiognomy, the head, skull shape. Once upon a time, during the attack phase in 2009, when I was a target, somebody I went to in Manhattan on the massage table fondled my skull from behind and said, "You have a nice, good-shaped skull." And I thought, uh-oh, next thing is the hacksaw comes out. But it didn't happen. It wasn't to be. Fortunately, I didn't stay long. So, forehead, yeah. Forehead, you see Weibo, not Weibo Sayadaw, yeah. Is it, who is it? Mingun Sayadaw, the one who looks like, Chico Javier, Francisco Javier, looks just like Mingun Sayadaw. Big forehead. The head of the, Advaita Vedanta root school, Adi Shankara, Shankacharya, Adi Shankacharya, the head of the lineage in India coming out of Adi Shankara. Huge forehead, huge. And that is not simply, it's vocalization as the product of brain development. And then the mechanics of neck and jaw. And people with a small jaw, a thin neck, pencil neck. The pencil neck and the small jawed has problem with vocalization. Why? Well, it's some karma from past lives. It's some kind of karmic return. Anyway, I should continue. So, but within a generation of generation and a half, 30, 40 years, what we see is the inception of humanity on Earth. Interesting. 1911, Don asked, "Can you tell me how this new bodily complex was suited to third density lessons and what those lessons were?" Great question. Ra replies, "There is one necessity for third density. That necessity is self-awareness or self-consciousness. In order to be capable of such, the chemical complex of body must be capable of the abstract thought. Thus, the fundamental necessity is the combination of rational and intuitive thinking. This was transitory in second density forms, operating largely upon intuition, which proved through practice to yield results. The third density mind was capable, or should be, capable of processing information in such a way as to think abstractly, and in what could be termed useless ways, in the sense of survival. This is the primary requisite. There are other important ingredients, the necessity for a weaker physical vehicle to encourage the use of the mind, the development of the already present awareness of the social complex. These also being necessary, the further development of physical dexterity in the sense of the hand, as you call this portion of your body complex." Be aware that there are adept practices for hands. There are real adepts do real practices for all sorts of portions of body that have effect on brain and mind and expanded awareness also. So the one necessity for third density, the one heart, pith, core quality of light that is intrinsically third density, the yellow, is self-awareness. Self-consciousness, self-awareness, synonymous. I use these terms technically. Consciousness is self-awareness. Consciousness is intrinsically subjective. thus illusory, based on, the five skandhas, the clinging aggregates under avidya. One takes aggregates for a substantial separative selfhood. When that's finished, one is beyond fifth skandha consciousness, or it doesn't arise. Then there's the sentience could be called awareness. So awareness as post-subjective perception, and continuing subjective perception or subjectivity is called self-consciousness or consciousness. Consciousness is self-consciousness, which is a diminution, is a dimming of non-dual awareness, which is satchit or tat sat chit. So that's what yellow is all about, is self-awareness, self-consciousness, which is basically light becomes aware of its source but cannot yet activate, access it. The crucifixion of the yellow. The crucifixion of yellow. Sanjigen, as we say in Japanese. Sanjigen. The jigen of sun. E-R, sun. Is, a very, we don't want to get into that here, but it's a very challenging existent, a challenging condition for the logos as well, it seems. So the chemical complex of body must be capable of abstract thought. So the body function, in many ways, evolution of awareness as expansion of perception is coincidental, parallel, intrinsically bound up with, and inseparable from increased capacity of body or form. The body as a form, here we have a chemical fleshy body, which is the form of third density self-consciousness. The form, the mind is willing, but the flesh is weak, or the flesh is willing, but the will's not there, or something like that. The form and consciousness go together. There's no expression of third density consciousness without some type of third density form, whether it's physical or astral. And so form, energy, consciousness go together. Form is simply a manifestation of energy. So, you have the one infinite, then you have light, then you have energy fields, then you have matter. And as we have light, we also, as light goes to energy, it also goes to self-consciousness, which doesn't end until leaving sixth density, by the way. Meaning identity is broken, eight fetter, leaving six, not leaving three. So the body must be capable of abstract thought. It's just an important thing, and so you can know the mind by the body to some degree, except beings that are very high may choose a particularly strange or damaged body for one incarnation. And beings that are very primitive and even negative may have the right to a beautiful form body, healthy, strong, beautiful, handsome, whatever. Those are not rarely the form of negative entities in planet Earth. So heads up. As well as a lowly developed soul that was kindly and generous may deserve a beautiful form in one incarnation, but the mind is quite crude. Not unusual as well. So it's simply that if you don't understand this chemical complex of body, or body must be capable of abstract thought, you're not understanding that evolution is a is the development of intertwined consciousness energy, energy fields consciousness, moving to awareness and freedom from the need for energy fields, the return, returning from energy to light, returning from consciousness to unbound awareness. That is the destination of the evolution of intertwined energy and form with consciousness, self-consciousness. Then, the third density mind, with an appropriate third density body, was capable of processing information. To think abstractly, and in useless ways. Well, humanity specializes in useless ways of thought, without a doubt, which is very, very nice. However, they're not evolving too much if they keep repeating. And then there's the hand development. So, very, very interesting. 1912, Don asks, this seems to be a carefully planned or engineered stage of development. Yes, this transition from 2 to 3. Can you tell me anything of the origin of this plan for the development? The development of body form from animal, plant to human, 2 to 3, commensurate or comparable, coincidental with the development of consciousness from mind-body to mind-body-spirit, self-consciousness. Well, 1912, Ross says, we go back to previous information. Consider and remember the discussion of the Logos. With the primal distortion of free will, each galaxy developed its own Logos. This Logos has complete free will in determining the paths of intelligent energy which promote the lessons of each of the densities given the conditions of the planetary sphere and the sun bodies. So we've got galaxies with stars and planets. The stars with planets are sun bodies with planetary spheres. They have conditions. Those conditions are such that any one planet may or may not be capable of supporting even second density life, but some can support life 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Some suns wink out midway, and the planet only supported life in certain densities, like Deneb. The Deneb sun was old, the old Deneb sun. And they came here rather than continue third density there, or second density, third density on some planet associated with Deneb came here and moved into East Asia, so they say, according to Ra. But so not all sun bodies thus can host dimensional life, meaning seven-dimensional evolving beings, or 2 through 6, really, on planets of those suns, but some of them can. Each galaxy developed its own Logos. Each galaxy is a galactic Logos. So you've got Logos as a focalizing of intelligent infinity into what's called intelligent energy, or capable of wielding intelligent energy, although it's consciousness or awareness, right? Non-subjective. Its awareness is near infinite or infinite enough. It then determines by its free will its laws, the bylaws of the galaxy. Then you have solar logoi, or a differentiation of the one galactic logos of each galaxy. Each galaxy as one being, of course. It's a logoic galactic logos is the one being. When then in that galaxy some of the suns have planets, then and can support those planets to second density life, then that sun body differentiates in a very subtle way, I would imagine, to become what's called a solar logos. And then that solar logos, or galactic logos, with a subtle, you know, kind of a, it's kind of a little jiggle, I think, a logoic jiggle. It's like a jiggy-jiggy, jiggy-jiggy, as Will would say. So this little jiggle, the logoic jiggle, turns it into a solar logos, which is not much different, and makes its own laws in determining the physical and metaphysical laws of its octave, of its solar system microcosm of the octavic macrocosm, meaning the seven-dimensional system is now is now made or available or is tuned into somehow by that portion of the galactic logos, now called solar logos. See, this is why all these words are so, you know, difficult. The solar logos is not different essentially from a galactic logos. It's simply a galactic logos associated with a particular sun body in a particular solar system where a particular planet or several can host second density life. So, this is so far beyond human scientists. They're just very stupid, actually. Most of them. There are some brilliant ones, but they're generally from elsewhere. These humans are much too grubby. Grubby, power grubby, power grubby grabbing. Power grabbing grubby. How's that? Power grabbing grubby. To appreciate how little they know and how much there is to know, and the truth doesn't need proof. Of course not. So, proving is great, but where it's unprovable, truth can still yet be found. They don't want to say that. They're very concerned with place and position and reputation. Anyway, we have then galaxies, suns, planets, physical conditions that may or may not support hosting to third density. But here in the solar system, we've had the conditions for a long time hosting dimensional life. And that's interesting. So this is a very special solar system, you know. It's really a. It's probably a sacred so-called solar system, as if are any not, but there's something kind of unique. Even everything's unique. So you see, these words are really shitty, right? It's the only thing we have to communicate specificity. You can communicate love or light or something subtle without words, of course, telepathic. But even telepathy is commonly thought form transmitted. It's a transmission of thought form. There's a rote, as Robert Monroe said, or a gestalt, or a composite whole transmission as well. It's transmitting sort of the knowing of integrated thought forms, the knowing that is based on an integration of multiple thought forms. Even that, though, is based on kalpana. So it's very that's again the cross, the yellow crucifixion. The yellow crucifixion, the crucifixion of yellow. That's just the poignancy of this level of existence. Aware of boundless promise, yet incapable of manifesting it. In continually pushed and pulled by veiled mind and animalistic body. Sometimes following body, sometimes turning against body. Sometimes enjoying or feeling delight in body, sometimes feeling agony in body. Love hate to body, love hate to spirit, love hate to the personal, love hate to the depersonal, love hate to becoming, and love hate with non-becoming. This is the cross of changes. This is the yellow crucifixion, the crucifixion that is yellow. Very, very much so. So, okay, 914, next section. 2D Earth apes harvest to 3D Earth humans. Oh ho. 914, Don asks, then there were second density entities here prior to the approximately 75,000 years ago. What type of entities were these? Meaning, who was around before the inception of the 3D cycle? Ross said the second density is the density of the higher plant life and animal life, which exists without the upward drive toward the infinite. These second density beings are of an octave of consciousness, just as you find orientations of consciousness among the conscious entities of your vibration. Don said, "What?" Well, that's kind of a complex answer, kind of whiplash. So, second density, like all densities, can be understood as a spectrum, spectral, the spectral dimensions. Okay, so there's a spectrum, all dimensions of consciousness with appropriate bodies is of a spectrum and a continuum with higher and lower, bell curve type of thing. So, okay, we've got a spectrum, we've got a continuum, higher plant life, higher animal life. Interestingly, you've got lower and higher. What does this mean? Higher plant life and animal life, which exists without upward drive toward the infinite. The sense of self is not there in a co is not coalesced. That's why they're not mind, body, spirit entities. However, there is consciousness and growth. There's not self-consciousness, but there is consciousness. And there is growth in that there is a seeking, but there's not a sense of self in the seeking. The plant seeks light. The frogs seek happy parties on the pond, at the nightly pond action here. So birds of a feather seek to flock together, and yet they don't have a sense of self. Yet that sense of self is germinal in so-called higher plant and animal life. But that wouldn't be called an upward drive towards the infinite. It's the yellow crucifixion, the crucifixion of yellow, the condition of the human, where there is a consciousness awareness of an infinite to which we ought to go, that there is a boundlessness, there is freedom. It's basically the crucifixion of yellow is knowing that the perfection of complete and perfect freedom is possible, yet not being able to attain it. Only the great Virya heroes who broke through 10 fetters in body have done that here. Nobody else. I mean, it doesn't have to be Buddhist, but so there's an upward drive towards the infinite because of self-consciousness. And then, okay, there's an octave of consciousness just as on Earth, and that's a, you know, useful matter. I mean, when we meet people, we really can get some sense where they are operating from. Well, we presume they're all third density entities. Only sometimes do we see reptilians in human form, or animals in human form, or fragments of thought form in human form. That's not so common. An astral detritus in human form. You can find them in certain places. And generally, they're humans. But there's various orientations of consciousness among conscious entities of this vibration. Various orientations of consciousness also means various grades or levels of development, spiritual development. But spiritual development means a development of awareness, which means how well they know and accept what they are. I mean, it's not a problem that Advaita Vedanta frames the path in terms of self. Just like it's not the only way in which Pali Buddhism frames the path in terms of ignorance, freedom from ignorance, or breaking fetters, or anatta. You can talk about freedom can be achieved by careful use of the paradigm of self, the construct of identity. The path can be trod without any significant dealing with the construct of identity. Both, I think, are fine. So, but there is a consciousness, there is a spectrum of development, obviously, which is a spectrum of awareness and capacity. Greater awareness goes with greater capacity. Greater capacity allows greater awareness. They go together. That's the evolution of energy and consciousness. And we can see some people walking around who are 3.1 and some people walking around or not walking who are 3.6, meaning their level is significantly below or above the diaphragm. Above, they would be polarized or committed to either moral path, either path of morality, paths of polarity. Below the diaphragm, they're more or less stuck, wounded, or in the negative path. That shows there too. And so individuation by love from 2 to 3, supporting second density beings evolving to third by necessary quote individuation, which is awareness of a greater awareness of true nature, light. That's also what those below the diaphragm need to live above the diaphragm, to make their home in green, blue, indigo. Those who don't can, but they would have to seek beyond the habitual. So there is a spectrum, and that's visible for those who can see it. 915, did any of these second density entities have shapes like ours? Two arms, two legs, head upright, walk on 2 feet. Ross said the two higher of the subvibrational levels of second density, meaning 2.6 and 2.7, something I think like that. The two higher of the subvibrational levels of second density beings had the configuration of the biped, as you mentioned. However, the erectile movement which you experienced was not totally affected in those beings who were tending towards the leaning forward, barely leaving the quadrupedal position. These are the knuckle draggers. So there is bipedalism, bipedality. Ooh, it's bipedality. In the two higher subplanes of second density, but they were knuckle draggers, more or less, or leaning forward. You can sometimes see people walking like that. Sometimes it's a holdover of the simian. 916, where did the beings come from? That's a loaded question. Were they a product of evolution, as it's understood by our scientists? Were they evolved from the original material of the Earth that you spoke of? Ross said this is correct. What does that mean? Yes, they were a natural product of evolution. What do you mean they? You mean their body? You mean that consciousness? Were they evolved? You mean the body? You mean the consciousness? You see, one has to go very deep and, soundbite culture. AI will replace yogis. When that happens, it's all over. Although it seems to be approaching that point now. What's the they? Ross said this is correct. What's correct? And Don wisely questions further, do these beings then evolve from second density to third density? What beings? Beings that evolve, evolve? Ross said this is correct. So it's a little vague here, right? This is correct, although no guarantee can be made of the number of cycles it'll take an entity to learn the lessons of consciousness of self, which are the prerequisite for transition to third density. The prerequisite for transition to fourth density is to learn the ways of love. What is love? Well, it's seen differently on the two paths or by those seeking and developing on the two paths. Love of all versus love of self. But the negative so-called love of self, which is a term Ra used, love of self, is not green ray love. So it's not even right to call the negative, learning in third density to learn the ways of love of self. You see, even the, this much has to be reworked to really come to go deeper. A lot of rearrangement is needed. The negative, learn the ways of love for love of self, so-called, as Ra said, to harvest a 4D negative from 3, is actually is sort of a self-glorification. It's the glorification of pride and vanity and identity. It's a glorification of the center point of consciousness. And it's an ever greedy, sucking, taking more, 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 more. The black hole. It's endless reception or taking, but it's not like pure reception, it's taking. It's endless grabbing, endless glorification or enhancement of identity, of the one that considers itself an identity. And the negative and the positive path is really the ways of appreciation of totality, or appreciation of other self, appreciation of human life, appreciation of everything, anything. But particularly heartful gratitude that appreciates what is. This is a certain way of understanding, learn the lessons of love on the positive path to graduate from 3 to 4. Anyway, yes, there's no guarantee the number of cycles to learn the lessons of consciousness of self, meaning go from animal or plant or tree to human. Likewise, nope guarantee on how many humans human lives are needed to learn the ways of love on either path. The negatives are doing their darndest to keep as many as possible from harvesting, and that's their goal. And they're succeeding very well. And, you know, I'll need a long consult with one of the representatives of the council to make peace with this logoic desire to continue this and allow this. So anyway, I hope that's useful. Next time we'll pick up on the at 9.6, Guardians bring Martians via genetic manipulation cloning. So I hope you appreciate this. I would assume you do. I hope you're well and appreciate the light and air in the room and space and freedom of spaciousness. So, in any case, take good care. See you next time, and good night.